unify the whole plotline for her mythological rewrites. As a result of this original adoption by the Nazis of Blavatsky's symbol signifying the East or the Oriental left-hand path to enlightenment, the error persists to this day that the Nazis were perpetuating the lineage of the Eastern secret chiefs or transcended Mahatmas whom Blavatsky claimed constant contact with. The symbol shown here from the modern Raelian UFO cult, containing the Nazi-oriented swastika inside the hexagram, perverts Blavatsky's intended meaning of these symbols as the Eastern and the Western mystery traditions to mean the Nazis and the Zionist Hebrew diaspora who stole Palestine from the indigenous Muslim Semites to form the nation of Israel. Before there was a nation of Israel, or a Nazi Party Third Reich in Germany, following Blavatsky and Levy's use of the hexagram symbolism, a group was formed by English and French Freemasons and Rosicrucians devoted to the study of Kabbalah and calling themselves the Golden Dawn, who attempted to unify the entire Western mystery tradition into a single cohesive whole in the form of knowledge lectures given in an order along with initiation rituals given per degree. The logo of the Golden Dawn was thus a hexagram showing a sunrise above an ocean, meaning their summing up of the Western mystery tradition was an attempt to provide Blavatsky's myths with a working dogma to unify her New Age mythology. The origin of the founding charter for the first Golden Dawn group, the so-called cipher manuscripts, remains a mystery in itself. However, regardless of their origin, the works done on Kabbalistic topics and concepts by the members of the Golden Dawn group were entirely their own work, and a wonderful collection of additions to Kabbalistic Western mystery tradition. In this Golden Dawn depiction of Adam Kadmon as Christ, we see the angels whose wings support him are labeled RC for Rosy Cross, that his body contains the 32 mystical paths of wisdom of the Tree of Knowledge, and that he stands on a globe between the symbols of the sun and moon, signifying earth as Malkuth, the kingdom. In this Golden Dawn group depiction of the Garden of Eden prior to the fall of man, we find God as an older Adam Kadmon, suspended by the Sephirot on a cross before twin pillars, below which stands Shekinah, surrounded by 14 branches, the seven planets twice, on the Tree of Life, atop the coiled representation of the seven-headed serpent called Set by the Egyptian, Typhon by the Greeks, and Satan by the Hebrews. The fall of man, as described by Israel Rigardi and A.E. Waite, members of the Golden Dawn group, resulted from the shattering of the shells in the layers between the three Kabbalistic worlds above Isaiah, and when it was mimicked within the spiritual composition of man, caused his fall from immortal Kadmon to mortal Adam, and resulted in his exile from paradise. According to Waite, Rigardi, Mathers, Crowley, and the others in the Golden Dawn group, this slippage of the middle pillar results in an 11th non-sephirot opening on the middle pillar between Kether, the crown sephirot at the apex, and Tiferet, meaning beauty and positioned above the heart along the middle pillar of man's spiritual composition, the template of Adam Kadmon. This hole within the figurative veil of the abyss they named Death, meaning knowledge, after Gnosis, meaning the quest to know. In this second Golden Dawn group depiction of the Garden of Eden, we see the same characters after the fall of man and the expulsion from paradise. Below the triple-faced angel, we see the Sephirot as a flaming sword. Above the arms of the cross, we behold the four elements, and consuming Adam Kadmon and the Sephirot on the cross are the seven heads of the great Leviathan, the red dragon of revelations, loosed from the pit by Eve. In this Golden Dawn depiction, we see the seven-headed serpent called Set Typhon, or simply Satan, consuming Lilith, Adam's first wife before Eve, who we behold crucified onto a cross, alike the Christian mythos of Jesus Christ. And in this depiction from the Golden Dawn era of 20th century Kabbalism, we see the three supernal Sephirot on a tree of knowledge with lowered middle pillar Sephirot, where Adam Kadmon, the cosmic template, as an old man, stands with his crown in Da'ath, his arms extended above the left and right columns below their supernal caps, and his feet resting upon Malkuth, the kingdom, the nadir Sephirot. So we see that now, at the turn of the 21st century AD, we who study Kabbalah have come a long way from the origins of our craft in studying the nature of our cosmos. In this familiar depiction from the mid-20th century Philosophical Research Society, a later adjunct of the Golden Dawn group, of Adam Kadmon as a philosophical atlas, supporting the 12 signs of the Babylonian zodiac at the levels of Da'ath and the Veil of the Abyss, and covered over by the 7 orbits of the planets at the level of the Veil of the Temple, with 1 foot on land and 1 foot in the sea, alike the Angel of Revelations. The western path of ascending the 10 Sephirot on the Tree of Knowledge is the path to reunion of one's being with one's own genius, higher self, or holy guardian angel. This path forms the quest set upon by the soul, once it awakens within the body while alive, or at the time of death, and sets its desire to returning to reunion with the single, omniversal spirit of Adam Kadmon's Godhead mind. The one soul is a microcosm reflecting the one spirit as a macrocosm. Hence, we are all gods, and reflections of God in one another's eyes, and all of us together are the one true God. In Legends, Part 2, The East. Part 2a, The Atman. Part 2a1, Similar Systems. Just as in HaKabbalah's Sefer Yetzirah, the origin of mankind's knowledge and understanding of the meta-pattern mold for human capacity for oneness with divinity are the 10 fingers signifying the 10 Sephirot emanations on the Tree of Knowledge, and thus representing also the manner of clasping the hands together in supplicant prayer during a Kabbalistic meditation. So too, in the far eastern Orient, do we find this ornate alabaster replica of a human hand, showing all the eldest Vedic equivalents to modern aspects of palmistry. The fingertips are shown as all one type of shell, the first knuckle as 5 types of gems, the second finger bones as eyes, the second knuckles as 5 types of flower, the usual mounds of the planets showing the planets in color and vivid detail, and lines shown as Vedic gods Ganesh, Hanuman, and Shiva, symbolizing the trinity of past, present, and future, are the same as in modern Western palmistry. Likewise, just as in the Western mystery tradition, Kabbalah is expressed as 4 worlds, and these 4 worlds are seen as equivalent to the 4 elemental forces of nature, on earth below and in the cosmos above, as seen here arranged, blue for water, red for fire, green for earth, and yellow for air, clockwise from the upper right, surrounding spirit, the 5th element shown as a local wheel from Buddhism, in a pentagram formation. So too, in the Vedic Eastern Oriental version of Kabbalah are there 4 elements also, or tattvas, called from left to right, Tejas, red triangle of fire, Patavati, yellow square of earth, Vajas, gray crescent of air, Apas, blue circle of water, and acacia, purple ovum. Each of these, as shown, contain the others to form the 25 tattvas, elements, of the material world. Likewise, just as in the Western mystery tradition, there is the element throughout the myths regarding the number 7, from the 7 archangel sigils over each day of the week, and 7 cameo talismans showing these sigils' places in the zodiac. And just as there are 7 gematria number squares, 7 Olympic gods of the visible planets, 7 powers of the Gnostic archons, 7 Christian churches founded by apostles, 7 lower sephirot subtended to the supernal trinity, 7 Greek vowels and correspondent Hebrew letters, etc. So too in the far eastern Orient there is a system of 7 attributes that is well known and far more ancient than even the Babylonian zodiac. The 7 chakras, or 5 nerve centers in the spine and 2 in the brain, form the evolutionary ladder up which our nervous system grows over time. These nerve centers, when considered in one's own human body, are held as infinitely more important in the East for understanding the nature of one's own soul and for achieving the full capacity for one's potential development than all the correspondences in 777 could ever be. Furthermore, just as in the Western mystery tradition, we have the typical wheel of 12 signs of the Babylonian zodiac, which can be read in the usual direction from Aries around to Pisces, for the 12 annual months per one solar year, or read in the opposite direction, from Pisces around to Aries, to measure the 2,000 year each 12 solar aeons in a calendar based on polar precession. So too do we find in the far eastern Oriental Chinese calendar an identical system of 12 zoo animals. However, rather than measuring months or aeons, each measures a single year in a never-ending 12-year cycle. For example, I was born in 1977, in the year of the snake. The year of the snake repeated in 1989, and in 2001, and will repeat again in 2013. Such is the Chinese equivalent to the Babylonian zodiac showing constellations in the night sky. Lastly, even the concept of assigning the 12 signs of the Babylonian zodiac to aspects of the anatomy of an upright human being originated in the Far Eastern Orient. This Middle Dark Ages graphic depicts an open torso dissection of a human cadaver, labeling each part with a sign from the Babylonian zodiac. This model is very much like the standard Chinese diagram of similar applications from the schools on the 12 Qi meridians for a good reason. They describe the same system. The concept of the 12 Qi meridian system, developed by Chinese Taoists, is based entirely on actual human physiological anatomy, structured such that each of the 12 meridians, nerve fibers extended from the spine into the face and torso organs and the extremities of the limbs, branches forth from one of the 7 chakras, nerve centers along the spine and inside the brain. Similar meridians have been found occurring in other mammals, such as horses and dogs. However, beyond this, more research does not remain forthcoming with the current Communist Party ban on the study of Qigong, Tai Chi, in China. The Atman, Part 2A2. 7 chakras, 12 meridians, and the Akashic Aura. The 7 chakras are the Muladhara, root, Svadhisthana, sacral, Manupura, solar plexus, Anahata,